Hello, I am Professor N.K. Pandey, and today I am going to speak on Zeeman effect. We know that a P level is split into two such levels, P3 by 2 and P half, because of a spin orbit interaction. Now, these levels will further be split into multiple levels if they are subjected to a weak magnetic field. So splitting off an energy level into a number of symmetrically equally spaced levels when a weak magnetic field is applied is what we call the Zeeman effect. Now, once the levels are split, then the transition between two sets of these levels, of course, subject to certain selection and intensity rules, give rise to observed spectral frequencies. Now, let us consider a vector model to better understand the Zeeman effect. The orbital angular momentum for an atomic electron is visualized in terms of a vector. Angular momentum vector is seen as precessing about a direction in a space. Angular momentum vector has magnitude L equal to square root L into L plus 1 into H cross. And this is how we can understand that the orbital angular momentum is a vector considered here in the figure. You can see, and this is precessing about any direction that we have chosen. Now, only a maximum of L units can be measured along a given direction where L is an orbital quantum number. Now, that means angular momentum vector is quantized. If it is quantized, it will have only certain selected values, and we will talk about them slightly later. Now, since there is a magnetic moment associated with the orbital angular momentum, the precession can be compared to the precession of a classical magnetic magnet caused by the torque exerted due to a magnetic field. Just like a small magnet is there in the magnetic field and it feels a torque because of the magnetic field. So the magnetic moment associated with the orbital angular momentum has the same effect. Now, this precession is called the Larmor precession and has a characteristic frequency called the Larmor frequency. The projection of this L angular momentum along a direction in space is quantized as we know it. This diagram here you will see, this diagram along L along a direction in a space is quantized. This diagram shows the possible values of magnetic quantum number ML for L is equal to 2. So this ML will range from minus 2 to plus 2. Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2, as you can see. So this angular momentum will have space quantization whose projection on any given axis will be, if L is equal to 2, it will be minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. Now this you can see from this figure, it will be very much clear that the atom can have, or the angular momentum associated with the atom can have only certain orientations allowed in a space. For example, we have these orientations of the angular momentum in a space, and correspondingly, their projections on this one will be like this, plus 2 H cross, plus H cross, 0, minus H cross and minus 2 H cross. So the angular momentum is quantized like this. It has only certain directions allowed in a space whose projection on this one will be given by what we call minus L to plus L. Once we have combined orbital and spill angular momenta according to the vector model, the resulting total angular momentum can be visualized as precessing about any externally applied magnetic field. So we have orbital momentum, we have spin angular momentum, and they combine together to make a resultant angular momentum. And this angular momentum may be considered to be precessing about any external axis in which direction we have applied the magnetic field. Now, this is a useful model for dealing with interactions such as the Zeeman effect in sodium. The magnetic energy contribution is proportional to the component of total angular momentum along the direction of the magnetic field, which is usually defined as the Z direction. the z component of angular momentum is quantized in values 1 unit apart. So for the upper level of the sodium doublet with j is equal to 3/2, the vector model gives the splitting shown. Now you can see here that for j is equal to 3/2, we have values of splitting mj is equal to +3/2, +0.5, -0.5, and -3/2. And this is S, this is L, and this is the resultant J, which is precessing about the magnetic field. L star and J star, these angular momentum vectors, they precess with uniform speed around J star. When atom is placed in a weak magnetic field, mu J associated with Pj is equal to, where Pj is equal to J star H by 2 pi, causes the atom to precess like a top around the field direction H. Now, quantum conditions imposed on this motion, that is the projections of J star H by 2 pi on H direction, can have values MH by 2 pi, where M is equal to minus J to plus J, that is 2J plus 1 values. Now, the discrete orientation of atoms in a space, as we have seen earlier in the figure, and the small change in energy due to precession, they give rise to various discrete Zeeman levels. Now, the number of these levels is determined by the mechanical moment J star H by 2 pi. Magnitude, how much will be the separation between these levels, is determined by the field strength H and the magnetic moment mu. In the field free space, energy level is determined by N, L, J. And in the presence of field, energy level is determined by N, L, J, M. Now, the relationship between the magnetic moment and mechanical angular momentum is given by this formula. Mu L upon PL is equal to E by twice MC, where mu L is the magnetic moment, PL is the mechanical moment. So, mu L is equal to, because PL is equal to L star H by 2 pi, so mu L is equal to L star H by 2 pi E by twice MC R per Gauss. Much in the same way for spin, mu S by PS is equal to E by twice MC, and correspondingly, mu S can be given as twice S star H by 2 pi E by twice MC per R Gauss. Here you can see, because an electron precesses about its own axis twice, and therefore we have two number over here for the spin, which is missing in the case of orbital motion. Now here we can see through the figure a very significant point. That is, we have S star, we have L star, and this is the resultant J star. So the magnetic moment associated with this spin will be pointing opposite to this one in this direction. And the magnetic moment associated with orbital angular momentum will be pointing in this direction, so that their resultant mu ls will be pointing in this direction. Whereas if we have the resultant J star here, we do not have mu ls pointing exactly opposite, that is along mu j. Therefore, if J star precesses around, let us say, magnetic field, then while precessing about this axis, all the components of this one perpendicular to this will get cancelled in the circulation. Whereas the component of this one along this direction will add up. So to the magnetic energy contribution, we will only have the contribution of the component of mu ls, which is parallel to J star or mu j, we can say. And this is what we can see in the figure over here, that S star, L star, this is the resultant, and the, although it should have pointed out in this direction, no, but the resultant of the magnetic moment associated with this and the magnetic moment associated with this is pointing in this direction. So we need to consider only the component of mu ls along J star and not the perpendicular component, which mutually cancel each other in the precession process. Now, what is the component of mu l along J star? You can see from here, this is L star H by 2 pi E by twice MC into cos L star J star. You can see from here, we can take the cosine function of this one, cosine function of this one. So similarly, we have component of the magnetic moment associated with the spin along J star, and that will again be given by 2 S star H by 2 pi E by twice MC cos S star J star, that is angle between cos, the angle between S star and J star. Now, total component along J is how much? So very simply, it is L star cos L star J star plus 2S star cos S star J star, and outside the bracket we have H by twice M E by twice MC, which is common to both. Now H by twice pi E by twice MC is equal to one Bohr magneton. So this particular value in the bracket we take as equal to J star G. So J star G is equal to L star cos L star J star plus 2S star cos S star J star. And we know the triangle law. If we apply the triangle law between S star, L star and J star, then S star is equal to S star square is equal to L star square plus J star square minus 2 L star J star cos L star J star. Now, similarly, by the triangle law, we can say L star cos L star J star is equal to J star square plus L star square minus S star square by 2 J star, and S star cos S star J star is J star square minus L star square plus S star square by 2 J star. So in this way, if we go back and from here, this is J star G is equal to this much. So once we have calculated these values and transferred J star to the right hand side in the denominator, we get G, and that value of G comes out to be 1 plus J star square plus S star square minus L star square by 2 J star square, which on decomposition will give you 1 plus J into J plus 1 plus S into S plus 1 minus L into L plus 1 by 2 J into J plus 1. Now, magnetic interaction energy, that is mu J by P J. Now what we have, because of the combined contribution of the angular momentum, that is the magnetic moment associated with the orbital angular momentum and magnetic moment associated with the spin angular momentum, we have the combined effect. So magnetic interaction energy, if we need to calculate, then in the same way that we had written mu L by PL or mu S by PS. So similarly, we can write down mu J by PJ is equal to some factor G into E by twice MC, where G is known as the gyromagnetic ratio. Here PJ is same as the earlier one, J star H by 2 pi. So the precession of J star around H is the resultant of a torque acting on both L star and S star. If the field is not too strong, the coupling between L star and S star remains intact, so that J star remains constant and J star is able to precess with a compromised angular velocity. That compromised angular velocity is given by omega L is equal to G H into E by twice MC. Here G is again the gyromagnetic ratio. Now energy of precession is given by the product of this angular precession speed with component of J star H by 2 pi along H. So the energy of precession will be given by delta tau is equal to omega L, that is product of omega L with component of J star H by 2 pi along H. So we have J star H by 2 pi cos J star H, component of J star along H. Now from here we can write down for omega L, GH E by twice MC J star H by 2 pi cos J star H. Going slightly ahead, we know that this is equal to the projection. J star H by 2 pi cos J star H is simply the projection of J star along the magnetic axis, and that is nothing but MH by 2 pi. Now, so delta tau is equal to, we can write from here, GH E by twice MC into, for this whole, we can write down MH by 2 pi only. So we have M G H E H by 4 pi MC. Now let us divide this delta tau by HC. Then the interaction energy will be converted into the wave numbers. So the interaction energy in wave numbers will be given after division by HC as delta tau upon HC is equal to M G H E by 4 pi MC square. Now you can see from here, we have divided by HC so that the interaction energy gets converted to wave number. So delta tau upon HC we have brought from HC, we have divided over here. So this becomes C square, and we have H we had, so that will get cancelled. So delta tau by HC, that is the interaction energy in wave numbers, is given by MG into HE by 4 pi MC square per centimeter, because we have converted that to wave number. Now here, HE by 4 pi MC square is called Lorentz unit. We call this one as Lorentz unit. So we have this, let us write down this one as gamma, then this becomes mgL, that is mg Lorentz unit per centimeter. So the splitting, because of this weak magnetic field, is given by this mgL per centimeter. Now, selection rule. As an example of the calculation of Zeeman pattern, let us consider the simple case of a principal series doublet like sodium yellow D lines. So we have doublet P half, doublet P 3/2, and doublet S half. So let us calculate the value of doublet P half, for doublet P half, the value of G. And then we are reminded of the formula for G, and that G will be calculated from here. Now, for example, for P 3/2, this J will be given as 3/2, S is half, and L for P is 1. So G can be calculated from here, either it is for P half, P 3/2, or S half, or whatever the term is there, we can calculate the value of G. And the splitting, because of in the magnetic field, is given by this formula, that is tau is equal to mgL per centimeter. So for doublet P half, G value is 2/3. For doublet P 3/2, G value is 4/3 according to that formula. And for doublet S half, G value is 2. Now, this, let us see that the splitting is basically mgL unit. So what we have to do, we have to calculate the G values and we have to find out the M value. For example, if it is P 3/2, the M values will be plus 3/2, half, minus half, minus 3/2. And this M value needs to be multiplied by the G value of that term. For example, doublet P 3/2. And then the magnitude of the splitting will be mg Lorentz unit. And that is what we have done over here. That is, this G star for J is equal to 3/2 had its component, that is 3/2, half, minus half, and minus 3/2. Now we calculated the value of G for this one, and the value of G for this one was 4/3, you can see from here. So what we have done, we multiply this by 4/3 over here. So this becomes 6/3, this becomes 2/3, this becomes minus 2/3, and this becomes minus 6/3. So this is the splitting, symmetric splitting of these line, original lines in the weak magnetic field. That is, doublet P 3/2 is split into 4 such levels. And here we have those levels shown clearly. We have earlier, we had from the doublet finer structure, we had P 3/2, P half, that was the center of symmetry, let us say. And this was because of the spin orbit interaction, this is S half. So this is in the field free. These levels are present in the field free. There is no field applied. And this, once we apply the field, then this level P 3/2 is split like this, plus 3/2, half, minus half, minus 3/2. P half is split in plus half, minus half, and S half is split in plus half and minus half. Exact what is the splitting, magnitude of splitting is given by mg Lorentz unit. Now, to get the spectrum, we have to go for certain selection rules. So that means only those transitions will be allowed out of these levels for which delta M is equal to 0 or delta M is equal to plus minus 1. So let us see for a couple of such levels, which levels are allowed and which ones are not. For example, from minus half to minus half, the change is 0. So this is allowed as delta M is equal to 0. From here to this one, that is minus half to plus half, the change is minus 1, it is allowed. So from here, that is plus half to minus half, the change is 1, it is allowed. And minus half to plus half, the change is minus 1, that is allowed. So these are allowed. But here also, those allowed transitions are shown, which are following the selection rule like this. But let us consider a transition from plus 3/2 to minus 1. The change will be delta M is equal to 2. And therefore, this transition from plus 3/2 to minus half is not allowed. So this way, what do we see? That we have 4 lines over here and 6 lines, that is 10 lines are present now. Earlier, we had one transition from here and one transition from here. We had doublet. And now we have 10 lines present in the spectrum when the atom is subject to a weak magnetic field. Now the same can be seen over here, that we had these two such lines over here that we had, and now these lines are split into four, and these are six, that is 10. That is no field, we have these lines, these two lines, and in the field, we have 10 such spectral lines present. Thank you very much for your attention, for your kind attention.